Students, let us discuss some questions from the chapter polynomials. You asked certain queries, so I thought of recording this video. So the first question is, divide minus 39 x raised to power 4 by root 13 x square. Now how you are going to do this division? Yes, we will be writing like minus 39 x raised to power 4 upon root 13 x square. Now you see in this question, minus 39 x raised to power 4. This is the numerator. So how do you write 39? 39 can be written as a product of 3 and 13. Right. Now observe that 13 can be written as root 13 multiplied by root 13. This you have learned in the chapter squares and square roots. Do you remember this? You have done the reverse part of it. Root 13 multiplied by root 13. How do you write root 13 multiplied by root 13? Yes, it is square root of 13 into 13. And when you simplify, you get answer as 13. So here what we will be doing is we will be writing 13, which is there in the numerator, as root 13 multiplied by root 13. Now it is very simple. From the numerator and the denominator, you can cancel square root of 13 and you can see that final answer to this question is minus 3 root 13 x square. This is left. Is it simple? Okay. For more practice, let us move on to the next question. Let us discuss this one. Okay. Here the question is, divide square root of 125 y square by 5 y square. Very simple one. How you will be writing it? Square root of 125 y square upon 5 y square. We have to simplify this. Now, square root of 125 is square root of, yes, 5 into 5 into 5 and then y square you write like this. Upon 5 y square. Now, you observe carefully that this square root of 5 into 5 into 5 is 5 root 5. You know how I have written this. Again, you have learned this concept in the chapter squares and square root. So square root of 5 into 5 into 5 is 5 root 5. So in the numerator, first you can cancel y square with the y square and then you are left with 5 root 5 divided by 5. And then again, you can cancel 5 with 5. And what is the final answer? Final answer is root 5. Okay. So let us discuss one more question. So don't worry at all. You can acquire the skill of solving such questions. Very simple. Okay. This question is divide 49p cube by minus 7 root 7 p square. Again, here you see you will be applying the same concept which we did in the first question. 49 is 7 into 7. And at the place of 1, 7, you can write 7 as root 7 into root 7. You see this 7 is splitted into root 7 into root 7. And now you can simplify the numerator and the denominator and cancel and you get the answer as minus root 7 p. So let us see this again. So 49 p cube upon minus 7 root 7 p square. First, what we have done, p cube upon p square, that is p raised to power 3 minus 2, that is p. So the next step is at the place of 49 we have written 7 into 7, p is left, 7 into 7 p divided by, in the denominator it is minus 7 root 7. So this is equal to, now 7 is written as root 7 into root 7. Now we can cancel from the numerator and denominator root 7. And then we can cancel 7 also from numerator and the denominator. And we are left with negative sign root 7 and p. So minus root 7 p is the answer. Okay, let us take another question. Here also you have done this earlier. Now see this one. Divide y square minus 5y plus 1 by minus 1 by 3y. Now you see this is a very interesting question. A trinomial y square minus 5y plus 1 is to be divided by a monomial, that is minus 1 by 3y. So we will be writing it like y square minus 5y plus 1 upon minus 1 by 3y. Now you know that when a trinomial or a binomial has to be divided by a monomial, we split or we separate the terms in the numerator and divide each term of the numerator by the denominator, because denominator here is a monomial. So what will be the three terms now? So three terms will be like y square upon minus 1 by 3y. This is the first term. And then the next term will be minus 5y upon minus 1 by 3y. And the last term will be 1 divided by minus 1 by 3y. Now you see minus 1 by 3y is in the denominator. So when you have to take it to the numerator, what you will do? You will write its reciprocal. So what will be the first term? First term will be y square multiply by, yes, 3, yes, 3 upon minus y. What will be the second term? Minus and minus, it will make this term as plus now, positive. So 5y multiply by 3 upon y. Very good. And what will be the next term? Minus 3 upon y. You see here also you can see this term 1 upon minus 1 by 3y. That means we have to write down the reciprocal of minus 1 by 3y. So what will be that? It will be minus 3 by y. So simplify this. Now you know how to simplify this. So when you simplify this, then you get the answer as minus 3y plus 15 minus 3 upon y. So practice such questions, and these can be asked in the examination also. So do not worry at all. So by practicing, you can acquire skills of solving such questions. All the best.